act. And don't you see, don't you agree, the contract says you'll sing exclusively for me. And though I failed to pay you money that was due, that's no excuse for you to break your promise too. It doesn't do, I'll have to sue you. But if I sue, what can I do? The only losses that are provable are few. You'll have to sing, I want that zing that your performing at my theater could bring. It may be true, I can't compel your voice, but I can take away your other choice. That's what equity is for, that's why we have a chance of more. For people who refuse like you to carry out their part. My dear, employment law is at a very early stage, and any rights you have now been signed away. In British law, la dona non è mobile. We had a pact, and though it's true that I defaulted first on that pact, a contract, a solemn contract. You broke our contract, so you'll sing with no one else.
Good. Now, let's have no more talk of your performing anywhere else, but what? What did you say? Efficient breach?
Efficient breach? Efficient breach? Do you endeavor to insult me with your speech? The profits I could earn are high. They'd be at least as high as any other guy. If it's efficient, let's negotiate. It's no more costly than to litigate. But to get me to agree, all the gains must come to me. Not to you and not to he, because it all belongs to me.
See? The contract even says that I should get all the gains from renegotiation. Well, maybe it doesn't say so explicitly, but that's the way people like me will interpret it.
My dear Miss Wagner, you should understand your place. A contratrice is considered a disgrace, and so
the three.